Let us see how do we configure BOM on ERPNext. So we will begin with configuring BOM for the most basic sub-assembly that needs to be manufactured in order to manufacture the finished good, which is the weather sensor. So in order to manufacture the weather sensor, the most basic sub-assembly or the first sub-assembly that needs to be manufactured is the PCB assembly. So let us see how do we configure the BOM on ERPNext. Let us create a BOM for PCB assembly. So we'll create a new BOM. We will define the item as PCB. So now the things that we need to define on the BOM is, first we will begin with what are the materials that go into making this particular sub-assembly. So we can add multiple items at a time. Let us say a resistor. We need one resistor, one transmitter, one battery, and one LED. So basically these are the raw materials that are required. Now the next thing that we need to define is what are the operations. So we need to click on this particular flag with operations. The next thing that the system will ask you is transfer material against. You will select work order, because if you were to transfer material against each operation, that will be a little tedious and cumbersome. So that's what we do on that particular field. The next thing that we need to define here is what are the operations. So I'll define just one operation, which is assembly, PCB assembly. So I have configured the default workstations at the operation level, so this will pop up automatically. Now in order to load the cost, we need to define the operation time. So in order to make it brief, I'll define the operation time of just half a minute, and the hourly rate at that particular workstation I have configured it as 1200 rupees. So once I save this, it will show me that the operating cost is 10 rupees. I'll save this. So this is the BOM for PCB assembly. If you scroll down, it will show you a breakdown of the costing. The operating cost is 10 rupees, raw material cost is 40 rupees, and the total cost is 50 rupees. So this is how we configure BOM in ERPNext. So similarly, we will go ahead and configure BOMs for all the sub-assemblies. So I have already configured BOMs for various sub-assemblies and the finished good on ERPNext. So we've already seen how do we configure BOM for the PCB. Then I've configured BOM for the next sub-assembly, in which the input is the PCB that we manufactured in the last step, and there is an additional operation of programming that PCB. We've defined the operating cost and operating time, which gives us the total operating cost and total raw material cost and the total cost of manufacturing this particular sub-assembly. Now if we look at the final product's BOM, we can browse it and take a look at what is that particular item made up of. So in order to manufacture a weather sensor, we will need a programmed PCB and an enclosure. But in order to manufacture a programmed PCB, we will need a PCB assembly, which is again made up of these particular raw materials. So we've successfully configured our bill of material. In the next step, we will see how do we take up the production planning and how do we actually go ahead and manufacture the finished goods.